going live right now. My name is Paloma, and I am the marketing coordinator at Karma Teachers. But today, we are hanging out with Katie Connolly, who is Karma Teachers' new executive director. And I just want to take a moment to introduce her to you. So, as we connect with Katie, let me just figure this out. She should be joining us shortly in a few minutes, but I'll just tell you that she started off mid-quarantine. She joined the team mid-quarantine, and she's done a few remodels at the organization. Let's see where she's at. Sorry about that. Where are you at, Katie? Let's see. There we go. Yay! She's just connecting.
Yay!
Yay!
We did it!
Yay! Welcome. So I was just telling our viewers, our future viewers, that you joined us mid-quarantine. And I just was hoping to give you an opportunity to tell us a bit about yourself.
Yeah, that's a broad question.
How did you want to join the Karma team?
I found out about Karma Teachers in 2012 from the original founder, Emerson. And I think it was through looking up kids' yoga teacher training. So I did my Rainbow Kids then. And then I did a yogathon, a kids yogathon with Karma that year, that summer. I kind of just stayed in touch. I did my 200 hour in 2014 and continue to stay in touch because I think like it's just such a beautiful community and I love the values. And just that so supportive for everybody. So yeah, here I am.
Yay, welcome. So you've recently joined our team. Well, actually, you've been with Karma since 2012. Right? Is that right?
Yeah, kind of been on and off.
On and off, okay. But you've recently joined us as the executive director. Do you have any goals in mind for our organization? Any that you're willing to share?
I'm an open book. I think the focus right now is really just on creating a little bit of structure and boundaries and a little more clarity. So, we all know our part in moving forward and how we can do that and how we can support each other because that's really the essence of Karma. So just finding more ways to share the organization and with those who need it.
Yay! I'm glad. Also, so I see that you're joining us from your channel. What is cranial sacral healing?
So cranial sacral is a bit of a blend of modalities. So cranial sacral osteopathy was created off of cranial sacral and it deals more with the bones. So helping to find alignment within the bone, hence the osteo. Chiro also is a variation off of cranial sacral. Working primarily with the spine and the nervous system. Craniosacral encompasses both of those. So working through the fascia to see the holding patterns, making misalignments of the bone with the fascia, feeling into the nervous system of the client. And I also do have another component with that called somato-emotional release. So if you've heard of somatics or somatic work, it's bringing the void to that piece. So, soma, I mean body. So obviously in our bodies, we know as yoga instructors, we hold a lot of our patterns, we hold a lot of, patterns.
Trauma.
Very often trauma, trauma of various sorts. So trauma is anything that our body isn't ready to process. So it becomes stored in the body. So as children or as babies, we might not have the communication forms to be able to articulate what's going on. Or if we're, say, in an accident, our body shuts down, basically goes into a dorsal vagal state, so we can cope with whatever's going on in that instance. So we end up storing a lot of the information within our body, which can be helpful for the moment, but it then needs to be released. So we don't, in the Western world, do a lot of dancing, shaking, or voice work, and that's where this comes in. So if we were able to do more of that, I think it's a wonderful thing to definitely dance with you for voice. I know I can too. We're allowing our body to let go of a lot. And yoga and breathwork is absolutely a big thing for that. So yeah, I work with clients either in silence, or if I notice something being held in their body, we bring light to that. So as a healer, you're only a guide. So you're bringing up sensations that their body wants you to help them with. You're not directing energy where they don't want. It's really whatever their body is willing to share. Yeah, we work through that process.
So, it does sound pretty amazing. I know from personal experience that I could use some practice with my voice. So what does that look like in a yoga class? You mentioned meditation or breathing. Do you have to do it on 101, or can you do it in like a full yoga class?
No, I mean, I bring in elements into my yoga classes, and I didn't realize, but I kind of always did. So I'm in the middle of, I guess, recreating my style of yoga. I'm a nonstop learner, so I'm always bringing in more pieces. Yeah, but it's fun. It keeps life interesting. So from obviously sort of a physical standpoint, certain.
Hi, everyone.